Yeah, Reaper back at your ass again, black at your ass again, and we back on another one today. But first, we would like you to subscribe to the Reaper because we doing good things here at Reaper. And go to my website, jazzbonareaper.com, and support your main nigga on the trigger. All right, we got a very interesting show tonight, and the Reaper is going to be giving you the Strawberry Letter 23 because I'm going to talk about independent women. Do they think they need a man? The independent woman, she thinks she needs a man because, they talk about house, they say, I don't need a man, I pay my own bills. Isn't that a part of being grown and responsible? The Reaper keep it 1,000. They say, nobody brought me a car, meaning no man has bought me a car and job. I got my own career, and they got a sense of independence, feeling worthy, not being controlled by a man. And, education, we all know that they say, I'm an educated woman. I got my degree. They think they educated, and they think they smarter and better than the man. But this isn't true because women learn life from men. Be it they lover, they brother, they uncle, they cousin, they daddy, somebody they learn from, how to navigate and, through life and the games people play, the Reaper keep it 1,000. So, women generally learn off of men and, they learn the common sense that you need to have, that element that you use 24 hours a day. Not saying they don't learn it from women, but generally, a man can teach a woman how to navigate through life and, the games people play, because he will tell her to look out for this and look out for that, and somebody's trying to get over on you on this and that and this and that, and then kids, most you think you don't need a man, to raise kids, and but you have kids by men with no ambition, you know, but to just throw dick, and you feel comfortable with this because it makes you feel powerful. I mean, most kids will feel empty. You're not thinking about their mental state. And, you know, most kids learn that their daddy ain't shit by the age of 10. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So, and then you're competitive, competing against the man, always wanting to control the situation. They don't want companionship. They want ownership. The Reaper keep it 1,000 of the relationship. And, you know, they feel challenged all the time by what he does or what he says. You know, if he's a good man, the Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, and, you know, they only think they need a man for sex. You know, I mean, these type of women, you know, think they only need a man for penis because they don't want to know if a man has a job first or whatever. They want to know the size of his penis, you know, before they ask a question, you know, about where he works and what he does. And some women just go celibate because, you know, they can't find the type of man, you know, that fits their criteria, and they don't want to put themselves out like that, and, you know, or for religious reasons or whatever. But the Reaper contends is, you know, the Creator made men and women to work together, you know, even in procreation. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So you're going to be unbalanced, you know, if you don't have this in your life. So I don't know why some of these independent, educated women, you know, think they don't need a man, you know, or they only need a man for penis, you know. And, you know, a lot of them, you know, just want to be single or whatever. Or, you know, if they're in a relationship, they want to have male friends. They want to leave their options open. They have male friends, or they have no commitment. You know, they want to have options in a relationship in case they meet somebody better than you. Because some women will always trade up. The Reaper keep it 1,000, you know. But if she got a goofy ass nigga and he let her manipulate him, you know, and control the relationship, then she's okay with that. You know, I mean, she's okay with that because, you know, she feels like she's in control. Because like the Reaper said, it's all about ownership, you know, of the relationship, you know. And if they can manipulate these goofy ass niggas, then they will, you know. You know, and then if she's been on her own, you know, for a long period of time or whatever, you know, respect, she mistake respect, you know, as restrictions, you know. I mean, you know, they've been single for 5 years or more. And if they get into a relationship, they will mistake respect for restrictions, you know. They'll want to leave the house, you know, anytime they want to without checking in on you. They'll come home from work and say they've been at work late, and she may have been off at 3 o'clock, but she'll come in at 7 o'clock, and, you know, she wants to travel or go out with friends, you know. She even wants to have male friends and roll like she said. And they don't feel the need to, you know, involve you in decision making because they use making decisions. They're used to making decisions on their own. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And if you tell them, they will mistake respect for control and they will be unhappy. The Reaper keep it 1,000. They will call you insecure, juvenile, childish, unconfident, controlling, everything if you want to know where they are at and what they doing. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because they've been on their own too much, and, you know, they'll mistake, you know, respect, you know, as control. And career is over everything. The job is everything. They will do anything, you know, the boss tell them to do. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. They'll respect, you know, him more than they respect you. And, you know, the job is their vehicle to independence. You know, even if they have a man, you know, that makes good money, they will go crazy, you know, if they can't get to this job. And family things with some of these women, you know, become, you know, secondary to the job, you know. I mean, that's what they'll do. You know, if you ask them to, you need to stay at home with the kids and you may make good money or whatever, they may go crazy because they give up their independence. And one woman told me, you know, that even if her man was rich, she would work because she wouldn't give up all of herself to him like that. The Reaper keep it 1,000. $100,000. So they still want to roll, you know, single or whatever. No matter how much money you make, you know, they feel like, you know, they're giving up control, you know, if, you know, they have to stay at home and do the family things or whatever. So this is what some of these women, you know, will do. And they love working around men. You know, these women talk about women's rights, but they hate women. The Reaper, keep it 1,000. They don't feel comfortable around other women because they say that the other women is manipulative, they backstabbing, you know, they gossiping bitches, and, you know, they'll fuck their man. The Reaper, keep it 1,000. You know, I mean, you know, you know, they'll get a job with mostly men, and they work with men, you know, they will introduce the man, you know, to the other man, the Reaper, keep it 1,000, the man that they, you know, work with, and, you know, and some goofy ass niggas, you know, see nothing wrong with this, because she is convinced, she done convinced him, you know, that they just friends, or she can handle herself, or she love him, or, you know, his dick is so big and good, she wouldn't cheat on him, or whatever, you know. But the Reaper contends is, you know, a woman is curious, and a woman is a man's, you know, biggest weakness. You know, Eve was curious, and Adam, you know, was weak. The Reaper, keep it 1,000, and allegedly, some people believe, you know, the serpent got that pussy. The Reaper, keep it 1,000. That's how Cain was born. So the Reaper is just bringing some of these things, you know, into play that some independent, you know, single women think, or even if they got a man, they have an independent, you know, mindset. And this is what they'll do. And the Reaper got a show out to say, is the feminist movement, you know, running good women? Because women want to compete as compete with men and be masculine like men, and they say they don't, but they always feel challenged off of what a man says and does or whatever. And if they got a man that's outgoing and, you know, he can handle himself and, you know, he knows how to take care of himself, and if he's an asset man that's got career, job, and everything, they really feel challenged, you know, because most women want to be needed instead of wanted, you know. And the Reaper always say, when I need a car, I'll pick anything. I'll pick a bucket or anything, you know, long as it run good and get me where I need to be. But, you know, if I got good credit and I walk on a lot, then I'm gonna pick something that I want, you know, something that I feel comfortable with that's good for me, you know. So it's better to be wanted than needed, you know, because you may pick anything just to get by, you know, when you need it. And, you know, some of you be picking these men that don't have no ambition or whatever, but you feel comfortable with them, because when you get mad at him, you can say, don't drive my car, get out of my shit, I'm more educated, I'm more smarter than you, you be lost without me, and all of that. But with a man that's got assets, that's got his own career or everything, you know, you feel challenged by that, and especially if he's outgoing. Now, I like to get to the lady that rides with me, the lady that keeps it 1,000, Sweet and Sassy. What's up, Sassy? You know, you heard the Reaper talk about some of this stuff today, and, you know, what do you think? Why do you think some of these women, you know, feel challenged, you know, if they got a good man?
Well, I would say that the women that have a good man, they don't know how to deal with that man. They used to dealing with the man that they can control, or the man that they feel superior towards. But a lot of women say they don't need a man, but they want a man. If the right man comes along, they're going to get with that man, whether they says, you know, as much as they say they don't need one. But a woman that's been through some stuff, that's been through a lot, they tend to feel like they don't need a man because they done been through the struggle, and they feel like they can do it all by themselves. But, you know, everybody in relationship, you need that man, you need that other person, you need somebody to be there for you, you need somebody to love you, protect you, and show you the way, like you said. But, you know, some people that are educated, or some people, like you said, that have been by themselves for long periods of time, they just get in that mindset. Or, like you said, they feel the need to keep their options open, like something better is going to come along. But if you got something good, that's what you need to stay with, and that's what you need to work with.
Yeah, and the Reaper always say that, you know, the Creator made men and women to work together, and I only can go by what I see. I mean, if I see a woman and she's been without a man for a long period of time, it's hard for her to submit to a man. But, you know, generally she be bitter, and because she wants to be loved by somebody, she wants some companionship or whatever. You know, I mean, that's what make a woman feel whole, you know. I mean, if they have a kid, or some women get married or whatever, you know, they feel like they time clock is ticking and they have kids or they want to be married. They just want to experience something and want somebody to appreciate them, because women love compliments. And if they got a good man, you know, around that appreciate them, you know, it's just what type of man they want, you know, around them to appreciate them. And if they come up out of this mindset, you know, that I got to run everything, or I got to control everything, or I feel challenged, you know, because, you know, I got a good man or whatever, and, you know, he's outgoing and he take care of his business, or he don't need me or whatever, so I don't feel like appreciated, you know. And if they just work together with a man, you know, they'd be better off. Because what I see is, I see a lot of bitter women out there. You know, I see a lot of women that don't have men, and you could tell these women want to be loved, because when they see, you know, relationship, you know, and somebody is sticking in there, hanging in there, or whatever, they always got something negative to say about it, or, you know, they just want to feel loved, you know, by somebody, and it's just that somebody ain't came along, and a lot of these women feel hurt. They feel neglected, rejected, or whatever, or it's just the mindset that they've been raised with, that this is how a man should act, or a man should kiss their ass, or whatever. And this is why, you know, some of these, you know, independent, educated women, you know, will go out there and get a buster or whatever, because, you know, they may have ran across a good man before, and, you know, they was unhappy because they set into this mindset, you know, of how a man should be from their mama, you know, their grandmama, or other people, and they just don't want to submit to that man, or they feel like that man is, you know, in control of them or whatever, because they don't have to, you know, manage him. The Reaper keep it 1,000. With a man they have to manage or whatever, you know, they feel like he needs them, you know, and this feels like they want to feel needed instead of wanted, you know, so they feel like this man need me, and I, you know, it's all a power struggle inside their brain, you know, and I'm running everything and I'm controlling everything, so I'm rolling and controlling, so I feel superior and everything else, the things that they're not going to feel, you know, with an asset man. And they just don't be happy, you know, riding side by side or riding in the passenger seat. They want to drive the car. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And, you know, they want to run the relationship and they want to control everything. And, you know, when the man is smart or intelligent or and he's got his shit together, you know, they feel challenged and they turn into a competitor instead of a companion. And this is what goes on, you know, in our community, and this is why the Reaper is speaking on it or whatever. And then they will go out there and, you know, they'll have a baby because they feel like, oh, well, I know this dude, you know, he ain't got no ambition or whatever, Tyrone, and, you know, I know I'm with him or whatever, but I'm gonna have a baby by him, you know, you know, just to, you know, entrap him or whatever, but I know he ain't gonna take care of it, but I'm not looking for him to take care of it, you know, like that, because I can do it by myself and I want a baby. And the Reaper always contends that, you know, a child should be a two-parent decision. If somebody doesn't want to have a baby by you, you shouldn't have one by them, because they're going to be half-hearted in taking care of it. And some of you women will go out here and get men that's got no ambition, that's got men, that's got other babies by other people, and was unsuccessful in his last relationship or marriage or whatever, and you will have a baby by him, knowing that he's going to half-heartedly, you know, take care of that child, and, you know, and not be there for you, you know, like he should. But, you know, you feel superior in this situation, you know, because you know the guy is irresponsible or whatever, and you will go out and, you know, have kids by him. And then when the kid gets old enough, you'll tell him that their daddy ain't shit. And some of you have, you know, different babies' daddies, and you haven't picked a good one. Or if you have a good one, you know, you'll take the good one through a bunch of shit, just like the situation with DeMarcus Cousins or whatever. You know, I mean, just because DeMarcus Cousins was getting married and he's got his career or whatever, this woman is using this kid as bait. She's working through the kid, you know, to hurt him because she know he cares about the kid because he wanted the kid to be there, you know, for his marriage and everything. And this kid is 7 years old, and she's just saying for the hell of it, you know, just to get to him, that the kid can't go because him and her didn't work out. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And this woman, I don't know, she probably trapped Dark Marcus Cousins. Maybe she didn't, you know, but she's being vindictive by not letting him see the kid. That don't excuse him for saying he'll put a bullet in her head or whatever. I think that was just out of frustration, you know, or whatever, because I don't think he would do that because he makes too much money and, you know, he's got a great life. But she knows that. So, you know, she wants to punt. The only way that she can punish him is through the child. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And this goes with a lot of women I've saw, you know, that when a man loves his child or whatever, you know, and he's coming around getting the child, doing for the child, wanting to be a part of the child's life, you feel challenged by that because he's with someone else, and you will work through the kid and play mind games with the kid, you know, and try to make the kid hate their daddy or he ain't doing enough. I saw some of you greasy ass women do this. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Now, let me put the disclaimer in here. I'm not talking about every woman. I'm talking about women that do this kind of behavior, you know, for no reason. And you got a man that's trying to come around and get his kid and love his kid and teach his kid. I've seen some of you even hide the kid out to tell him, you know, when you're not moving or whatever, the nigga got to track you down and he's playing child support or he's got to go through the court or whatever. And then you will get with a man that's, you know, has no ambition, you know, and you have two or three kids by him, right? And, you know, you don't require him to do nothing because you feel powerful and you with him and you feel like you need him. And you'll be talking about the dad that's good, that come around and get his kid and take care of his kid. And you'll be laying up there with that buster every day and he ain't doing a motherfucking thing. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And then you'll be telling them that their daddy that's doing something ain't shit. No, you ain't shit. The Reaper keep it 1,000 because you know why? You know, because, you know, you done chose a buster that you feel comfortable with, that you can run, and just because you feel like you hold the purse strings and you got a college degree, you feel comfortable with this. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And this is what I see, you know, with a lot of women. And so the Reaper is speaking on this because this is what I see. Is there anything you want to add on this, sweet and sassy?
Yeah, I just want to say that, you know, for the women, if you do have a good man or a good man comes around, you need to get off your high horse with all that educated bullshit and all that and act like a woman, because the good man is going to be there, and that's somebody that you can work with and have a good life with. The bester that you find at the liquor store drinking a 40, that's just a person full of empty promises. And as far as the children go, if you do have a good father around, that's coming around, that's trying to be there for their kids and take care of their kids, let that shit happen. Because there's a lot of people that don't have that. And when you don't have that, you appreciate it. I mean, the ones that do have it, just like you said, they want to play a game with it and try to manipulate and try to run the situation.
I think that, you know, with the man that doesn't have any ambition or whatever, you know, that run through jobs and, you know, he's always cheating or, you know, in some cases combing ahead or doing all kind of stuff, you know, and he's coming in there running the situation or whatever, you know, he don't care if they go to the moon and back, long as they take care of him. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So they feel like in that situation, because, you know, they have more freedom and and they hold the purse strings that, you know, they rolling and controlling, you know. And so this is the way that, you know, some women feel. And with a good man, you know, he's going to have restrictions and everything, you know. He's going to make you have respect, you know. And some of these women, you know, mistake it for restrictions because they didn't have no restrictions, you know, if they was with, you know, a buster or whatever, because they was managing that situation. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So if they said, I need to make a run out of town or whatever, you know, I mean, you know, he could be working some little job and they could give him any excuse. And, you know, long as it sound legit, you know, and he knows that he can't make it without her, he will let her go out of town. You know, he won't go out of town with her. You know, I mean, she can go to the moon and back long as, you know, she pay bills. The Reaper keep it 1,000 just to, you know, make his situation comfortable or whatever. So she can do anything she want to do. But if she's with a good man or whatever, you know, some of those options are going to be, you know, limited, you know, because he's going to, if he's really into her, he's going to be checking up on her and making sure that things is, you know, done correct, because he wants things done in an orderly fashion or whatever, you know. So he's going to be checking to see if, you know, she's where she's at, or if these things are legit, if she's going out of town and doing everything. And, you know, he's not going to require her. She can't come home and say, you know, hey, I bought Tyrone home, and introduce him to Tyrone because she worked with Tyrone and he would be a good, you know, friend to you or whatever. She knows better than to do this kind of stuff, you know. And so she feels restricted when she's with a good man. And, you know, and then it comes down to the scenario, I can do what you can do or whatever. And the Reaper always contend that, you know, if I had a taste for some ice cream and I left the house at 12 o'clock or whatever, they say, well, I can do it too. You know, I can leave the house at 12 or 1 o'clock or whatever, you know. And, you know, it may not be feasible for you to leave the house at 12 or 1 o'clock. I may go get the ice cream for you. You know, what is you doing out there? And that's the protection that a man has, you know, for his woman or whatever. And I could understand if the man's gone for a long time, you know, and, you know, he don't come back with no ice cream, or he's gone and the ice cream is melted, or he's gone for a long time. That means that he's doing something that he ain't got no business. But if he making a run to the store and only take 15, 20 minutes and he come back with some ice cream, that means that he went to get some ice cream. But I'm just using this as an example. They feel like if you could do it, I could do it. You know, I could, you know, they equate everything to equal rights. And the Reaper always contend, okay, if it's equal rights, then if somebody break into the house or whatever, you go see what that noise is. And if it's raining outside, right, thunderstorming and everything, and the flat get on the tire, I'm gonna sit in the car and you go change it. I bet you if I did that, you would say I'm a motherfucker and I would be everything in the book, and you ain't no man, and you ain't this, that, and the other. So a lot of these women still want, you know, the advantages of women, but they want to be like men, you know. Is there anything you want to add on this before we get to the trending topics?
Well, I'll just say that don't continue to keep that mindset, because you're going to continue to be alone. You know, you need to, you know, work with that good man and have a happy life with that good man, and, you know, stop wanting to be in control of a man that's not worth being controlled of.
Yeah, and if you got the right man or whatever, you know, and he knows how to manage that situation, I mean, I know a lot of women, hey, that wouldn't mind that. They say it takes pressure off of them. But then I know a lot of women, you know, they don't feel worthy, you know, if the man is working and he grocery shops and he cooks dinner sometime and he makes her world feel more comfortable. She say, what he got me for, just a pussy, you know. So, you know, they want to feel needed. you know, instead of want it. And Maripa always contends that when somebody wants you, that means they choose you. You know, when somebody need you, they just may need, you know, somebody to get by. So, you know, this is the reason, you know, why we're having this discussion is because, you know, some of you women need to cut it out. Not all, because some women can vibe with a good man and, you know, they know, you know, what a woman's supposed to do and they don't take respect as restrictions. But a lot of these independent women, you know, and especially if they've been on their own for 5 years or more, you know, these are the problems that you're going to come across. The Reaper keep it 1,000, and you wonder, you know, why they single, you know, for a long time or whatever. So, you know, if you're a single woman out there, you know, you need to take some advice for the Reaper. You know, don't do these things, because these things can cause you not to get a man and stay single, you know, for the rest of your life. What you got on those hot trending topics, you know, today here for the Reaper?
Okay, we're going to start off with our celebrity news and start with French Montana.
French Montana.
He was mad as hell at his security guard because a man was able to get close enough to him to sucker punch him. He was leaving the Amish market in Tribeca, New York City. He was there for those VMA, Video Music Awards, when he was attacked by a guy in a red shirt from behind, and it set off a brawl with his whole crew. NYPD showed up to a fight, but everyone involved was gone. No reporter or assault was filed. French says, no blood, no foul, but he still pissed the hell off that his security let somebody knock his ass out.
I saw the video on this, and, you know, this brother was ranting and raving, and ain't nobody came up there and knocked him out or did nothing to him, and he was ranting and raving on his security, get over there, get over this, get over that, and it seems mostly staged to me, you know, because wasn't nobody, and then when the police came, he got in his car and left. How come when the police came, he would say, what's going on? When they saw the police, he hurried up and got in his car and left, so I believe that, you know, for this was staged. Staged or whatever, you know, they'll do anything for press and stage anything for press, and I'm not a sheep. And, you know, did nobody attack this brother? And he tried to slap the dude's video camera out of his hand, and he was ranting and raving. Okay, if somebody had just rolled up on him like that, how did the dude get up on him again with the camera to get the footage? But they wanted dude to get the footage because, you know, they wanted him to put it on TMZ or one of these things. And, you know, to see French Montana ranting and raving. If you notice, every time this stuff is caught on camera and TMZ, you know, gets a videotape or whatever. The Reaper keep it 1,000. So, you know, I mean, they just want some press. And French Montana, just want some press. You know, this nigga better be, you know, worried about if Puffy go roll up on his backside. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Allegedly. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Kobe Bryant. Kobe says he would have been in Bill Russell territory if Shaquille O'Neal wouldn't have been such a lazy ass during their Lakers days, claiming he would have had 12 fucking rings. Bryant was asked how Shaq would have been with his work ethic. And Kobe said, captivating, he'd be the greatest of all time, and he wished he was in the gym because he would have had those 12 rings. Shaq made a response on Instagram and says that if Kobe would have had them 12 damn rings if he passed the ball.
You know, all facts from all parties involved, because Kobe used to shoot the ball and the slogan was, pass the ball, Kobe. And Phil Jackson, you know, had plays to keep the ball out of Kobe's hands because Kobe used to shoot it so much. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, he was on his quest to be like Michael Jordan. But, you know, the Reaper always contends that, you know, Kobe Bryant wouldn't have had 12 rings anyway. I don't know why he's saying that. he probably would have had more if Shaq would have stayed in shape, because Shaq was always having Big Max attacks, and Shaq never stayed in shape, you know, when he was with the Lakers. Not like he should, because he was the biggest man out there, and he dominated everybody. Just imagine if he would have been in shape, but, you know, but Kobe wouldn't have had all these rings and things or whatever, you know, like he's saying, because, you know, he wanted Shaq gone, the Reaper keep it 1,000. So he wouldn't have had all of these rings like he's saying, you know, because he wanted Shaq gone, and he wouldn't have been the Kobe that he is today, you know, with a couple rings on his own. And he wouldn't have been the man like he was today, because all those MVPs and scoring titles and everything and 61-point games and 81-point games, he wouldn't have got if Shaq was there, because you had to feed the big man, the Reaper keep it 1,000. So, you know, I don't know what Kobe is talking about, but I don't think Kobe went any malice by it. You know, he was asked the question, and it's something that he ain't told Shaq, and it's something that ain't no that, you know, people don't know around the NBA, that Shaq never stayed in shape when he was with the Lakers, and he used to eat everything he want to. And he didn't say that Shaq didn't work hard. This is where Shaq took it wrong. He said they asked him if he had his work ethic, and Kobe, you know, he had a great work ethic. You know, I mean, this dude would go in the gym and work, and Shaq didn't go in the gym like Kobe and work. That wasn't saying that Shaq didn't work, because Shaq said that, you know, you can't get statues if you don't work hard. Well, that wasn't the question, Shaq. The question was, if you had Kobe Bryant's work ethic, you know, could have got more rings or 12 or whatever. Now, they wouldn't have got 12, but they would have got more rings. But of course, Kobe wouldn't have been the man, so he wouldn't have been satisfied with that anyway. But I don't think Kobe meant any malice by it. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Rick Ross.
Rick Ross, the boss.
He's finally admitting that a major seizure he had came from codeine abuse, and this what led him to hospitalization. He said he began using prescription opiates, recreationally, but eventually turned to large quantities to cope with stress mixed with drinking and other drugs he was doing and not resting. It almost killed him. He's finally coming clean because he's releasing a memoir.
Well, you know, they call that syrup, you know, and Rick Ross is on that syrup, you know, and they do drink that, is what, you know, down south or whatever. What did he do? He's saying he got hooked on it.
Yeah, he was abusing it.
Yeah, you know, and they, you know, he was getting high smoking weed, you know, I guess doing this syrup or whatever, you know, because they mix these pills, you know, with cough syrup and all of this kind of stuff or whatever, you know. It's called laying down south or whatever. I said these country brothers be, you know, doing some bullshit, because I'm not mixing, you know, prescription pills with with fucking cough syrup. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, I don't know who came up with that drink. They call it lean. They should call it heart attack. The Reaper keep it 1,000. Because, you know, that's what some of these niggas gonna be having. And Rick Ross apparently done got hooked on, you know, pills and all of this, you know, because they probably crush him up in the lean. And, you know, now he's, you know, crying out for help, I guess. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Kevin Hart.
Kevin Hart. Is Kevin Hart funny? No, I'm just asking. You know, I mean, you know, a lot of people say, some people think he funny. You know, some people said Dave Chappelle ain't funny. You know, but Dave Chappelle is funny to me. You know, I mean, if you see his new stand-up, he's a good storyteller, and he's funny to me. You know, I mean, but a lot of, Big Worm tried to say a lot of black people, you know, Faison Love, you know, I mean, tried to say a lot of black people don't think Dave Chappelle is funny and his comedy is for white folks. I think Dave Chappelle's comedy is for all folks, because Dave Chappelle is funny. You know, I'm just saying, because he could tell a story and just be funny in it, the way he looked and everything. And I know his stand-ups is funny. I don't know about, you know, if he did movies or not, would it be funny or not, you know. But I know his stand-ups is funny, and that Chappelle show was funny. But Kevin Hart, I don't think his movies is funny, and I don't think his stand-ups is funny.
Okay, we'll go to
you know, but he's funny to some people, you know. I mean, some people say he's funny, you know, so I guess who it is the funniest to, but, you know, most black people that I talk to or whatever say Kevin Hart is not funny. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. So why is he the leading comic out there now? Go figure. You know, what you got on Kevin Hart?
Well, he's been ordered to pay $700,000 to his former business partners who accuse him of screwing them out of millions. He has 60 days to pay. This decision ends a case that has been dragged on the past 2 years. They claim they set up many deals with Hart, with Coke, Verizon, Vitamin Water, Miller's and Coors, and hotels, and he terminated deals to stop them from paying the commission that they want, and they want their 15%.
So he stopped paying bills. Say that again.
He terminated deals that stopped him from paying his commission, but they want their 15%. They feel like that they were owed millions, but the judge ordered that finally that he just had to pay $700,000.
Well, this is to business associates that he had or whatever that was giving him deals. And, you know, I guess he wasn't paying, you know, the commission, you know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. Sounds like an agent or somebody to me, or an agency where Kevin Hart was not paying the commission and they were setting him up with business deals or whatever. So Kevin Hart is going to be on the hook for that one because, you know, if they're setting you up with business deals, and I'm sure they got a contract and everything, thing, you're going to be on the hook for that one. But I don't think he'll have a problem paying that because he's got plenty of money and plenty of shows and plenty of movies out there now for him to be unfunny. The Rookie at 1,000. Go figure. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Too Short.
Too Short? Too Short got teeth now. I remember in the 80s, Too Short didn't have no teeth. He said they call you Yuck Mouth. You know, shoot. He used to sound better when he didn't have no teeth. He had that twang in his voice. The nigga used to sound better and make better albums when he didn't have no teeth. The Reaper keep it 1,000. When he was Yuck Mouth. You know, and, you know, I mean, Too Short, you know, he had that twang in his voice because, you know, he could rile words off. He'd say, BS! Just call her a BS. You know, and that sounded funky in the 80s. Just call her a BS! BS! Could say bitch. He had no teeth in his mouth. What you got on Short Dog?
Well, he just signed a new deal to partner with the leading cannabis company and launch his own pre-roll joint. Short Dog is jumping into business with Green Holdings Group and White Angel Farms to launch his new line called Too Short Sticks. He says he's been a regular cannabis consumer for over 30 years.
Yeah, well, you know, he's probably spent a lot of money over 30 years, and now that weed is legal, he just gonna invest in it so he can smoke. You know, that's what Mike Tyson did. Mike Tyson got a show out called Hot Boxing with Mike Tyson, and Mike Tyson has to stay sedated because he had killed somebody. The Reaper keep it 1,000, and he said weed calms him down, and they were smoking $40,000. You know, I said this was some expensive weed. Mike was smoking $40,000 worth of weed a week, so they said you might as well invest in a cannabis company. That's a brother who smokes a lot of weed, you know, per month or whatever. And they saying, well, what you spend a year, you might as well invest in a cannabis company because you can make some money. And that way you can smoke for free because you'll get the stuff in bulk and everything like that. And a lot of people is doing that, you know, investing in a cannabis company. Some of these guys that smoke a lot of weed because they're spending a lot of money on weed. So, you know, why not put the money back into their own pocket? What else she got?
Okay, we'll go to Stevie J and Jocelyn.
Stevie J, your future and Stevie J throw more dick than a little bit. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And somebody need to tell these brothers because they got a bunch of kids to put something on your penis. you know, Stevie J and Future, you know, because if you don't put nothing on, it's too late now, you know, I mean, you know, I mean, you know, if they don't keep working or doing something or open up a business or something, or, you know, I mean, you know, they gonna be on one of those where are they now stories, because they got a lot of money going out a butt, because every butt or two or every year or two, they popping up with a couple babies. The Reaper keep it 1,000. What you got on Stevie J?
Well, a judge okayed temporary custody, awarding Stevie primary physical custody of Bonnie, who is 3 years old now. Jocelyn has visitation. Stevie will no longer have to pony up $1,000 a month in child support to Jocelyn. Both parents are taking parenting classes and are due back in court in the fall. He sued Jocelyn, arguing that she cut him out of their lives. He argues he's now more financially and mentally stable than Jocelyn and asked the judge to force Jocelyn to pay him child support. Jocelyn says she never denied Stevie and was doing her best to raise the little girl.
Yeah, well, you know, I mean, Stevie J only pay $1,000 worth of child support. I know some brothers that pay $1,000 that's just regular working class brothers. So Stevie must not have no money to be an entertainer. I mean, if he's paying $1,000 a month, I wonder how much is he making. I mean, he's wrecking Faith's bids and, you know, and hit and running somebody with no insurance on him. And, you know, he wants to get custody of the kid and, you know, it's probably, you know, because he married the Faith, they putting both incomes together or whatever, and he's saying that he wants custody of a kid. But Jocelyn, you know, that's a wild broad or whatever, you know, she gonna do something, and if Stevie want custody, he know all her secrets and what she doing and everything, and, you know, he just take that to the judge and say he's a married dude, and, you know, he's got a, you know, credible residence that they living at, and if he can show income and he married, you know, they will give him part-time custody of the kids if, you know, she's doing improper things or whatever, or he can, you know, have a better environment, you know, for the kid or whatever. And I think that, you know, she doesn't mind doing this. It's just for the money, you know, because she had a baby by him, you know, because she thought she was going to get more money. So I don't think she minds it right now, because she's only getting $1,000 a month. But that $1,000 a month could be helping her live. I don't know about in New York State where she live at, or if she live in New York State or whatever, but that $1,000 a month, it ain't nothing in New York State. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And, you know, even Stevie's, you know, career done took a backseat or whatever. So, you know, he doesn't have the money, you know, that he should. And, you know, he wants part-time custody so he doesn't have to pay even $1,000 a month. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to NFL's Ryan Russell.
Ryan Russell.
He was a former Cowboy and played for Tampa Bay.
Mm.
He says he's been getting nothing but support from the NFL circle since he announced he's bisexual. And they say the pass rusher is hungry for the next opportunity on the gridiron. He was spotted holding hands with his boyfriend the day after he announced his sexuality preference. In public, the former Cowboy draft pick says he's hearing from coaches and teammates in Dallas and Tampa Bay, and the feedback is all positive. Acceptance and tolerance are good. News for Ryan sounds like the NFL free agent would be welcome in locker rooms with open arms.
Yeah, he pass rushing. He sacking that ass. He pass rushing that ass. He sacking some ass. The Reaper keep it 1,000. You know, he's trying to do like that one brother did that got drafted or whatever, and he wasn't no good. He's trying to play the sympathy role to say that, you know, you let gay men into the NFL or whatever, you know, and the brother wasn't no good for the Rams. I can't think of his name right now, but, you know, he came out out and told everybody that he was gay or whatever, and then they wasn't discriminating against him because he was gay, and he got on the football field and he wasn't no good. So these men, the reason they let these things out to say that they're gay, because the Reaper always say, if you never told nobody you was gay, they wouldn't know. They only could suspect. That's why the Reaper say it's a behavior. It's not like civil rights. It's about accepting a behavior of somebody and a choice of somebody, then accepting, you know, them being treated like a human being. Because if you never told them you was gay, they wouldn't know. But, you know, these people come out of the closet because they think they're going to get sympathy or whatever, or they're going to get a roster spot or whatever because they're gay, and, you know, some owner is not going to discriminate against them because they're gay. But, you know, you got to be able to play even though you're gay. And if you can't play, you know, you're not getting in, you know, and, you know, but this is why they announce that they're gay and they walk around, you know, some of these athletes or whatever, because they think that, you know, some owner is going to, even though their play is not up to par, some owner is going to feel sorry for them and give them a roster spot. What else you got?
Okay, we'll go to Mel B from the Spice Girls.
Mel B.
Her ex-husband says she needs to share some of that fat wad she earned on tour with the Spice Girls, and he deserves a cut to help care for their kids. Stephen Belafonte is her ex. He filed new docs asking the judge to modify how much she pays him in child support. Currently, she pays $5,000 a month, but she recently racked in a massive $2.4 million for her Spice Girl reunion tour. He wants the payments to boost to $17,394 a month. The divorce was settled and agreed upon payments and custody schedule. He wants more. They will be back in court next month.
See, this just goes to show, you know, Mel B wanted a man that's beneath her, you know, because, you know, it made her feel comfortable, because $5,000 a month is good for any man if he got a career and he taking, you know, care of the kid, because obviously, you know, he's got custody because she's on the road all the time and she probably don't want, you know, custody of the kid. He could be a good father, but he's going back in for more cheese on her. Because, you know, the Spice Girls is the leading, you know, group. They done sold more albums than the Beatles. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And, you know, so he's going back in for more money because all of the Spice Girls is, you know, they're well off. You know, the Reaper keep it 1,000. They're rich. So he's going back in for more money just like a woman do, you know, on a man, you know. So I guess what's good for the geese is good for the gander, you know. So he wants more money to, you know, support the kid or whatever. Is that Mel B? Was she the one that was with Eddie Murphy?
Yeah.
Was she?
Yeah, because they got a divorce. They had a real bad divorce. And
was they married?
No, not her and Eddie Murphy. Her and the dude that's trying to get the money from her.
But do she got a baby by Eddie Murphy?
Yeah, she does have a baby by Eddie Murphy. They had a DNA test to figure that one out.
Yeah, and her and Eddie get along good now. And I heard she said in the news she wished she would have stayed with Eddie. But, you know, apparently she was fucking him, you know, while he was still married or going through a divorce. I don't know. You know, I mean, that one was dicey. You know, that's why Eddie didn't, you know, she entrapped Eddie. And Eddie told her he didn't want no kids or whatever. But she was trying to secure the bag, you know, like a lot of women. The Reaper keep it 1,000. And, you know, and all of that. So, you know, but they say they're good friends and, you know, everything is square now. And she's coming out and Eddie's married and, you know, Eddie got another kid on the way because, you know, his new wife, you know, done spit out a couple kids by Eddie, you know, and he's in his 60s. He's in his early 60s now. Eddie Murphy is. And, you know, he's still making babies and having kids.
Mel B claimed this guy that she was married to, the one that's trying to collect this money from her, was abusive, and they were in a real bad marriage, and she was always in the TMZ and everything else complaining about him, how he hits her and does all this stuff. But at the end of the day, he was the one that ended up with custody of the kids and everything else.
Yeah. Well, she, you know, hey, they always be with, you know, some abusive man, or they claim abuse, you know, when they bust up with a man, but everything was all good, you know, once they was with him, but they always claim abuse or whatever, you know, just to get away from him. I don't know one woman that ain't claimed abuse to get away from a man, or not to pay a man as much if he's got custody of the kids or whatever. You know, they always, you know, play the victim role when it comes to court proceedings because they're a woman and, you know, people will believe them. What else you got?
That's the end of our
stories. That's the end of the stories. And, you know, we like to thank Sweet and Sassy for her trending topics. She does do a good job. And don't forget to subscribe to the Reapa and thumbs up the show and share it with somebody. Reapa, we keep it rough. We keep it raw. We keep it real. And like I always say, we don't give a fuck, less than a fuck, about you haters. Reapa out. Peace.